But I think it becomes more and more undeniable that we have overwhelming evidence of the massive failure of the American capitalist system, hand in hand with the feeble democratic experiment called the USA. And what I mean by that is the three pillars, the financialization of capitalism that led toward not just Wall Street greed, but a level of unaccountability of capitalists, of economic elites, going hand in hand with a militarized U.S. nation state, externally manifest in attacks on Venezuela, expansions in Africa, drone still dropped, war still taking place, but internally having to do with mass incarceration, the massive militarization of local police departments, and the commodified culture in which everybody's for sale, everything is for sale, and militaristic metaphors, militaristic enactments in films, in videos, in movies, culture across the board, so that what is left are a few countervailing voices, figures, movements, and institutions, with at the moment a weakened people. That's why I think we're really moving toward a full-blown neo-fascist moment. But those voices, those figures, those movements, those institutions that are countervailing are very important, and that's precisely why when I begin with your longevity and your integrity as public intellectual, you've been a countervailing force against this capitalist failure, against this commodified culture, against this militarized nation state, all tied to money, 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 profit maximizing, but pulling out for a democratic, public-oriented, people-centered way of being, let alone public policies that speak to the needs of ordinary and everyday people.